December. Today we're the 13th of December, and I've been, you know, doing jolly things every day, and I wanted to show you guys some of my outfits. Every day I try to wear something jolly, something Christmassy. So
all of these are from my streams, except for these two. During my stream, I always wear a PG because I go to bed after. And last year I bought 3 Christmas PGs, and I have a redeem on my stream where I wear a headband. So I have like this one, it's a reindeer to match a reindeer's. This one is just, it made me laugh and I loved it. And this is a tree. There's a bowl missing, but so these are usually my outfits for the stream, and I have the socks that match. And when I don't stream, I have my normal PGs and I wear these. These are socks my mom bought for me for my birthday. So yeah. And no, I don't wear this. Today I'm streaming, and during my stream, I wear my Christmassy PGs. Then when on the days I don't stream, I still want to wear something festive. So I have these. I have my ugly sweater, which it's so cute. So I don't wear all of these together. I could. I could, but I do not. So I have this one, my ugly sweater. I have Christmas leggings, and I have a Christmas. This is personally my favorite. This one is my favorite. It's a Christmas cardigan. I wanted to show you how cute my outfit is today. So cute! I feel so cute. So yeah, I keep it festive. I also have this cardigan. I've had it for a long time. It was my grandma's. It has a lot of cat hairs on it. Cat hairs do love this cardigan as well. But it's a cat mom's problem. But I can also wear this for the jolly season. It is red. So I decided, like, I used to film videos on my desk, but I feel like it's less I look awkward. I look more awkward when I do sit down videos. I don't think I'm good at following a script. You know, it's good to know your flaws, you know. I prefer like talking like this. I think I'm better at just talking. This is my streaming thing, and I also have decoration for my stream. I have my advent calendar. When people give stuff, I decorate the tree. I have my cat's advent calendar, and I have candy canes, a Christmas candle. Hi. I know I said I wouldn't do another sit down video. When it's a themed month, it's harder to not sit down to talk. So, but I still decided to try and film on my phone because it's better quality. So yeah. Hi. I'll still try to make it as not awkward as possible. We'll see about that. I am quite awkward for this jolly month. I watched around 14
movies. I think I'm forgetting a couple. You know, December is kind of an hectic month, even January. You know, there's like parties everywhere, you need to plan for stuff. So, yeah. So, I watched Home Alone for the first time. I watched Nightmare Before Christmas, The Santa Claus, Jingle All the Way, Miracle on 34th Street, the 1947 one, A Christmas Carol, Four Christmases, The Grinch. I thought I had seen The Grinch, but apparently no. Also, Nightmare Before Christmas, it wasn't. That's the only one I hadn't seen. Something from Tiffany's, which I did a reaction to. So I just started watching a movie for my Christmas challenge, and it's already so predictable. It's insane. Like, it's called Something from Tiffany's, and this man goes to buy a ring for his wife, I guess, and another man goes to buy his, something for his girlfriend, and they both came out. And as soon as they came out, the second guy came out, I was like, oh no, they're like, we're going to be switched somehow. And then he just bumped into him, and then went away. I was like, okay, maybe I'm wrong, you know. But now the man got hit by a car, and the second man just put his bag next to the other guy's bag. So we know what's going to happen. We know. The whole plot of the movie is going to be like they switched the presents. Honestly. I kind of want to stop here. I kind of already want to stop the movie. I'm only 2 minutes and 53 seconds in. I already want to stop. But this is the cringe of Christmas.
You're not cringy though. Ooh.
So yeah. These are the cringe. I kind of was looking for it, to be honest. I was looking for a cringy movie and I have it, and I don't want to watch it anymore.
The guy that was about to propose is now helping the other girl.
And there's a vibe. And I'm not into it. Whatever this vibe is, they need to stop. They need to stop. No. No. What do you mean? You were about to propose to your girlfriend. And you're just going to... No. Okay, it's a little, not worse. It's a little worse and a little better. Because when I got into an accident, he lost his memory, obviously. And now he doesn't remember why he thinks he wanted to propose to his girlfriend. So now he proposed. This is a mess. Yep, they're falling in love. Of course they are. Of course. Of course they are. Anyway. And they're both unhappy in their relationship, and you know what's going to happen. We know, we all know, we knew from the beginning, okay? And yeah, the first guy got his ring back and proposed to his girlfriend, but they're unhappy, so. Why am I smiling? So I just finished a movie. They got together, and then jump scare. Jump cut to a year after they got engaged. It's cute, okay? It's cute. I don't support having vibes with someone else while you're in a relationship, but find her cute, okay? Yeah.
I also watched Violent Night, Bad Santa, Die Hard. People will say Die Hard is not a Christmas movie. I think the main actor from Die Hard says it's not a Christmas movie. But since it's on a lot of people's Christmas movie list, I decided to include it and watch it for the first time. Also watched A Castle for Christmas. I think I'm missing two. So I also watched Almost Christmas and Deck the Halls. So I'm at 16 Christmas movies. So yeah, I had some catching up to do, since I usually don't watch Christmas movies.
I also tried watching a podcast, a Christmas podcast story. It's called Welcome to Tinseltown. It's a kid's story, but it's Christmas time mostly. It's about kids, let's be honest. Adults don't really enjoy Christmas time usually. It's more for the kids. But you know, I wanted to be in the Christmas magic. So I listened to Welcome to Tinseltown while working. So that was fun. Also on Christmas Eve, I have three of these. I mean, my mom and my sister wear them for Christmas. And on Christmas, I put Christmas music pretty much the whole day, and I lit my Christmas candles. I couldn't go to my work Christmas party because I got COVID. Yeah, I got COVID, and I just, you know, you don't want to give COVID to people before Christmas. That's not a nice gift to give. But and since COVID, since the whole COVID thing happened, me and my friends, we haven't been doing a Christmas dinner together. We usually just see each other on we usually only see each other on New Year. We celebrate New Year together. And on Christmas, I did take a picture of me and my family's meal. Also, for my stream on Twitch, I like to play games that are related to my challenge on YouTube, and it's very hard to find video games that are Christmas related. So I played Batman because it's during Christmas. It happens during Christmas. Are the Arkham games like Die Hard or something? Can't you see how Christmassy? This is Christmas. I wanted also to play at first Spider-Man, Miles Morales, because it happens also during Christmas, but I will be playing it during another month. Batman is not that long, and I wanted another game, so what's more Christmassy than snow? I was hesitating between a wholesome game or something with snow, and I really wanted to play Tomb Raider, so I played Tomb Raider just because there's snow. I did for a Christmas activity, I did bake a fruitcake. It was my first time baking a fruitcake and first time eating a fruitcake. And I made eggnog for the first time as well. The first time I tried eggnog was a couple years ago, and it's the last time I did, because here we don't really eat fruitcake, nor do we drink eggnog. It's not traditional here, but I wanted to try them. And the eggnog, I put it in my coffee, in my matcha, in my what else, in my hot chocolate. It was just like, ooh, Christmas. You know. And I did film the process, so I will be inserting it here. Hi, and welcome to the kitchen. Today I will make a fruitcake and an eggnog. Both are my first time making them, so I'm following recipes online. And I don't think I've ever eaten a fruitcake, but apparently it's traditional.
In my family, we did not eat fruitcakes, and neither did we drink eggnog. So yeah. So the fruitcake, I won't know if it tastes right. I won't know. As long as it tastes good, right? As long as it tastes good. So I started the oven, and I'm going to start with the fruitcake because it takes longer to make. Yeah. So this is kind of episode 3 of my fake cooking show. With chat on Twitch, we decided on my butterfly seasoning. Last time I did my cooking episode, I was wearing my Cookie Monster onesie, and I called myself Cooking Monster. Yes. Even when they ask for unsalted butter, I don't like unsalted butter. It's going to go to waste. I don't like it. So I will not buy unsalted butter for one recipe. Oh no, the eggs should be at room temperature. Whoops. And I looked at it. Well, they won't be at room temperature. Should I sit on them to warm them up? Maybe it's kind of warm. Warm up. Maybe I could put them in water. Would that be okay? Warm up. Okay.
There's always something wrong when I cook.
What am I doing? Salt. We're now ready for you.
It's tiring. Mixing is tiresome.
Do I? They're so cold. Maybe I can warm them up. Is it bad if they're not room temperature? Asking for a friend.
It's kind of roomy, temperature-y. Kinda.
You need muscles to cook. I don't bake often. I cook more than I bake. It's not that I don't like baking. It's just that I eat savory things more often than I eat baked goods. I want to taste it. But there's raw eggs. I need 1 cup of crushed pineapple. I didn't see it. I don't close stuff. Oh, there. It's all open. But you can see it. You can see it. So I'm leaving it open. I feel like seeing it in the cupboard is personal. Especially on this side where the food is. I feel like it's so personal. Like you can see what I eat. My favorite stuff. I have ramen. I have a whole shelf for tea. Because I love tea. I should make tea right now. Although I'm sweating. And then I add nuts. It says walnuts or pecan. I forgot, but I have cashews. And I don't want nuts. It's not that I'm a nut hater, it's just that. I'm a hater in baked goods. I just think it's a crime. Can I not? I won't do anything, right? Should I add a little more fruits since I removed? Because you know, I removed the nuts. Okay, this is a fruit cake, not a fruit and nut cake. Now onto the eggnog. Oh no, there's a cracked one. No! I think it's freshly cracked. No! No! Munch on the rest of the
pineapple. I'll do it. It's such a tedious thing. Am I stressed? A little. I'm a little stressed. No wing! I broke it! I broke it. This is stressful. I feel like I don't know what to do with myself. Ah, stress. I still have 4 to do. And I won't add alcohol because I don't drink alcohol. I'm not against alcohol. Don't overgrow, okay, please? There, simmer. Definition. Below the boiling. We're kind of below the boiling. I would say we're below the boiling. I'm falling asleep. I'm so tired. Oh, I forgot the vanilla. Whoops. I'm just licking everything. Oh, I need to show you. Right? Hello! And nod. How rude of me. I have a song stuck in my head. And it's this girl that made up a song for her cat. And it's always stuck in my head. He's a burrito. Montito. I don't remember. I never remember the lyrics.
Cute little fluffy magical wizard Dorito. Montito. He is a triangular pyramidal burrito. Let him.
Also, reminder. Don't wait to wash your water bottle. I washed mine today.
I'm not hungry, but oops. But we need to taste it, right? Ta-da. It's not bad at all. And I like that there's no nuts. Do you guys like fruitcakes? If I offered you a piece, would you eat it? I'm so happy I was able to do it. I'm really proud. But yeah, bye.
What did I learn from December, from my jolly month, from the jolliest month of my life? It's very fun. I really enjoyed it. It is harder than I wished I would have did some Just Dance and practiced some Just Dance Christmas songs, but things happen very fast during December. Things happen too fast, and I just didn't have. I blinked, and the month was over. So, but yeah, I really enjoyed my month. I will for sure try to do it again next year. I just think it's fun. next year I will try to do Justin's Christmas dances. I need to do that. And now for January, I am doing a guitar challenge. I will talk about it more in my guitar challenge video, but yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video and you can comment down below and like, maybe subscribe. Thank you for watching and I hope I'll see you in my next video. Bye.